Okay guys, welcome back to my video. This is the second part of sequence and series. We will learn geometric sequence and series. A sequence in which every term is obtained by multiplying or dividing a definite number with the preceding number is known as a geometric sequence. Okay, so if the arithmetic sequence is addition or subtraction, this time geometric sequence is multiplying or dividing the preceding number. The symbols in geometric sequence is the same with the arithmetic one. So we have UN and A, but instead of B, we have R now. R represent the ratio between two adjacent terms. Okay, example one. Can you tell what is this sequence? Is it arithmetic or geometric? Okay, look at this. I have one, and then 2, and then 4, and then 8, 16, 32. Look at the pattern. From 1 to 2, we can say it's plus 1. But from 2 to 4, it's plus 2. It's already different. And then this is plus 4, and then this is plus 8. It's different, all of them. Okay, so we cannot say it's plus 1 or plus 2. Or maybe this time, it will be multiplication. Times 2, times 2, times 2, times 2, times 2. See? The pattern is the same. When it's involving multiplying, then the sequence called geometric sequence. So what do you think about A? A is the first number, the first term, it will be 1, and then the ratio is 2. If you hard to find the ratio, you can use the formula later. Okay, this is only the example of geometric sequence. Okay, the next is 54, 18, 6, 2, and so on. Let's analyze this sequence. 54, 18, 6, 2, 2 over 3, and then 2 over 9. Okay. Let's say it's hard, yeah, but we can try this one. From 6 to 2, it will I think it needs to be dividing by 3, yeah, dividing by 3, or I can say multiply by 1 over 3. This one is also multiply by 1 over 3. This one is also multiply by 1 over 3, and all of them. Okay, so if one more time, if it is involving multiplication, the sequence is geometric sequence. Okay, next. The next is the formula for UN, the N term. UN equals to A times R to the power of N minus 1. And the ratio will be ratio equals to UN plus 1 over UN. What is UN plus 1? UN plus 1 is the term after UN is the preceding term. Okay, look at example number 1. In sequence 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, determine the 21st term. 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, and so on. The 21st term will be the question is the 21st term. Next, we have to prepare the A and the ratio as usual. Okay, the A will be 1 and the ratio will be, if you hard to find the ratio, we can use the formula. Let's say we choose 4 and 2, so the ratio will be 4 over 2. Okay, the term after divide by the term before it. Okay, so the ratio is 2. We have A and we have ratio. The questions want us to find U21, so the formula is A times R to the power of N minus 1. A is 1, R is 2, N 21 minus 1. So So the result will be 1 times 2 to the power of 20. 1 times anything number, yeah, it will become its number itself, 2 to the power of 20. Okay, since we cannot use calculator, so we leave it like that. Next, example 2. In sequence 2,222 and so on which term is 0.00002 located? Okay, the question is which term? So the question wants us to find n. What is this? 0.00002 means the un. Yeah, so if we rewrite the sequence, it will be like this: 222 and so on until it comes into 0.00002. Okay, this is called the first term, this is the second, until the 0002 we don't know the end, so it is us. Okay, let's say the A is 2000 and then the ratio will be, let's choose this one and this one, 20/200 become 1/10. Because the n is us, we have to find it using un. Un equals to a times r to the power of n minus 1. The un is 0.00002 equals to a is 2000 and then r 1/10 to the power of n minus 1. Okay, 0.00002, we change it into fraction to be easier, equals to 2000 times 1/10 to the power of n minus 1. Okay, so far so good. Okay, move the 2000 to the left side, so I have 100,000. Divide by 2000, it means times 1/2000 equals to 1/10 to the power of n minus 1. Okay, next we can cross out the 2, so we will have 1/100,000 and then times it with 1000 equals to 1/10 to the power of n minus 1. Last step, we can change the 1/100,000 into 1/10 to the power of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 equals to 1/10 to the power of n minus 1. Since the 1/10 is already the same, we can cross out the 1/10. So I will be I will have 8 equals to 1 n minus 1. And then I will have n equals to 9. There you go. Cut. How about number 3? Number 3, we have a geometric sequence given that the fourth term is 200. So I can write U4 is 200. And then for this statement, the sixth term, I can write U6 equals to 50. Okay. We can expand the U4 using the formula A times R to the power of N minus 1 equals to 200. So I don't know N, I don't know A, sorry, and I don't know R, leave it like that. But I know the N is 4, so I pull the 4, oh, not 3, is 4. The 4 into the N equals to 200. And then I simplify it, AR cube equals to 200. Yeah, gitu ya. Okay, next is U6. U6, A times R to the power of N minus 1 equals to 50. So I don't know A, I don't know R. We have N, 6 minus 1 equals to 50. So I have A times R to the power of 5 equals to 50. This and this, we can using substitution to get the R or the A, yeah. But I have a trick for this one. We can solve it like this. So we have AR5 equals to 50. We can use division, yeah, divide by AR cube equals to 200, like that. Okay, and then we can cross out the A, we can cross out the 50 and 200, it will become 4, and then we can cross out the R cube and R5, it will become R square. So I have R square equals to 1 over 4. The next thing is we have to move the square into the right side. R equals to, remember, when we move the square into square root, we have to put plus minus at the front of it. So I will have two values of R. The first is half and the second one is negative half. I have R. And then we have to find the A. How to find the A? We can substitute this R and this R into one of them. Okay, I will put it into AR cube equals to 200. For R equals to half, if I put it into AR cube equals to 200, it will become A times 1 over 2 to the power of 3 equals to 200. A times 1 over 8 equals to 200. So I will get A equals to 1600. How about the R equals to negative half? It's the same. A times negative half to the power of cube equals to 200. And then I will get A equals to negative 1600. So I have this two set of A and R. We can use it to find the values of, wait, the values of, what is the question again? Determine the 10th term. So the question wants us to find the U10. Okay, use the first set of A and R first. Okay, U10 equals to A times R to the power of n minus 1. The A is 1600 times R. The R is half. Half to the power of 10 minus 1. Okay, let's simplify it. Equals to 1600 times 1 over 2 to the power of 9. Okay. The result will be 25 over 8. This is the first possibilities of U10. Next, using the second set of A and R, we will get the A is negative 1600, the R is negative half power 10 minus 1. Negative 1600 times negative half to the power of 9. The result will be also 25 over 8. Yeah, it is a coincidence that the number is the same. When the question asks U9, the result will be different. Okay, do not bother it. As long as you get two numbers of R, you have to calculate both of them. Yeah, do not forget that. The next one is the series, geometric series. Yeah, geometric series is the sum of terms of geometric sequence. You already know it at arithmetic. Okay, the sum is denoted by Sn equals to A times R to the power of n minus 1. Be careful, this minus 1 now it's on the below, okay, not at the power, over R minus 1 if R greater than 1. So in this formula we have two conditions. If R greater than 1, for example 2, 3, 4 and 5, we use the top formula. Okay, if R less than 1, we use this formula. Yeah, the difference is only the placement of 1 and R. Okay, example 1. in the series 1 plus 2 plus 4 plus 8 plus 16, determine the sum of the first 5 terms. As usual, if the questions want us to find the sum of a few number, it will be easier if you add them all manually. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 terms. Okay, the result will be 12, 28, 30, 31. The sum will be 31. But if the question wants us to find the sum of a lot of numbers, a lot of terms, like this, we can use the formula. Okay, first we have to prepare it. We have to prepare for A. A is 1. And then the ratio will be 8 divided by 4. 8 over 4 equals to 2. And then what is the question? The question want us to find the sum of the first 10 terms. So we need to find S10. S10, the formula will be A in the bracket. Look at the ratio. The ratio is greater than 1. So we use the top formula. R to the power of n minus 1 over r minus 1. A is 1, and then r is 2, n is 10, and then minus 1 over 2 minus 1. The result will be 2 to the power of 10 minus 1 over 1 become 124, 123. Okay, so the sum will be 1023. Next, the application of geometric sequence or series. Experts say if the people is not do social distancing, then the number of people with COVID-19 will double 2 times every 1 hour. If it is assumed that 00, the number of people with COVID-19 is 1 person, and the people is not do social distancing, then after 1 day, people with COVID-19 will become how much? Okay, so I will illustrate this first. At 0000, there are 1 people that are infected with COVID-19. Since the man is infected with COVID-19, he has a fever. Fever is colored with red. Yeah. Okay. Next, at 0100, if we do not do social distancing, this man will infected 2 more. Okay. So we have 2 new people right here. And then at 0200, these 2 men will infect 2 times more, 3, 4, and so on, until the question wants us to find the number of people after 1 day. Yeah, berarti 24.00. Okay, look at this sequence. We have 1 people at the first, and then 2 people, and then 4 people, and maybe this the pattern is times 2, yeah, times 2, and then times 2, and then times 2 again, become 8, and so on until we don't know how much people in this one. Okay, we can find the n first. The n will be, this is the first number, the second, the third. Look at the pattern. When it say 2, it is the third. So when it says 24, it is the 25th. Okay, 2, 3, 24, 25. Okay, so the n is 25. So what do we have to do? We have to find the S25, yeah, the number of people that infected by COVID, the sum 1 plus 2 plus 4 plus 8. The ratio is 2 and the A is 1. This is A, this is ratio. Okay, use the formula A times R to the power of N minus 1 over N R minus 1. A is 1, R 25 minus 1 over, oh sorry, the R is 2 ya. Yeah? Okay, so 2 minus 1. The result is 2 to the power of 25 minus 1. It will become, the result is 33,554,432 minus 1, 31 people infected. See? So, do social distancing ya. Do not go outside. Do not meet with your friends. Okay, the last is infinite series or the mathematical words is convergent. Infinite series is geometric series with ratio between negative 1 and 1. Infinite series have the sum of infinite ya, yeah, the sum of infinite the symbol is S infinite. Look at example 1. We have example 6 plus 3 plus 3 over 2 plus 3 over 4 and so on. Let's check the A and the ratio first. The A is 6 and the ratio is 3 divided by 6 ya. Yeah. 3 divided by 6 is equal to half. Since the ratio is half and half is between negative 1 and 1, so this series can be called infinite series. Yeah. If we calculate the sum till the 10th term, the result will be, so for the 10th term, the sum of the 10 first term, we have to add this until the 10th term, yeah. Plus the ratio is half ya tadi ya. 3 over 8 plus 3 over 16 plus 3 over 32 plus 3 over 64. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay, let's calculate this. The result will be 11.98. I use calculator. Yeah, okay. What if we calculate the sum until 100 terms? Or maybe until infinite terms? I will not do until infinite terms, I will do until 100 terms ya. Yeah. Let's use the formula of geometric sum. So we have A. The A is 6 and ratio half. A is 6 and the ratio is half. We can find S 100 equals to A times 1 minus R to the power of N over 1 minus R using series formula. Okay, A 6 1 minus R half to the power of N, the N is 100, and then over 1 minus R. The result will be 12. Yeah, okay. Look at this number. If we calculate the sum till the 10th term, the result is 11.98. If I find the sum until the 100th term, the result is 12. It's not different, yeah. If we round off this 11.98, it's also become 12. So infinite series will generate the sum of series close to one number. Yeah, if you calculate till the 10, it will close to 12. If you calculate until 100, it will close to 12. If you calculate until infinite, it also will close to 12. Yeah, so we can say the sum of infinite terms for this case will be equal to 12. Close to 12, yeah. The sum of infinite series, the formula is S infinite equals to a over 1 minus r. Example 1, determine the sum of infinite of this one. Let's prepare it first. First, we need a. So a equals to 10. And then we need ratio. For this one, the ratio is a little bit complicated. So we use this one and this one. The ratio will be 10 over 9 over 10 over 3. The result is 1 over 3. Okay, so we have a and r. The question want us to find the sum of infinite. The sum of infinite is a over 1 minus r. The a is 10 over 1 minus r, 1 over 3. The result is like this, and then 15, yeah, 15. Okay, if we add them up, it will close to number 15. Example 2, the sum of infinite series with ratio half is 20. So this is the ratio. I can write ratio equals to half. What is this? This is the sum of infinite, yeah. So I can write s infinite equals to 20. From this one, we can find a using the formula s infinite 20. We don't know a 1 minus r half. So we get a equals to 20 times 1 minus half is half, cross multiply times half, we get a equals to 10. Yay. We have a and ratio. The question wants us to find, determine the fourth term. The fourth term is U4 or S4. Come on, U4, yeah. U4 equals to, for geometric series, a times r to the power n minus 1. A, 10, ratio, half, n, 4 minus 1. So 10 over 8, yeah. 10 over 8 divided by 2, 5 over 4. The fourth term. There you go. And then the last one, the application. A ball is dropped from a height of 2 meters. So I have a ball here. This is a ball, yeah. Okay. And then it falls, yeah. It falls from the height of 2 meters. So it falls to the ground. This is the ground. From the height of 2 meters. And then the ball bounces. The height of the bounce is only 3 over 4 times of the height before bouncing. Before bouncing, the ball fall from 2 meters. So when it bounce, the height is only 3 over 4 of 2 meters. 3 over 4 times 2. 3 over 4 times 2. How much? 3 over 2, yeah. So it will bounce 3 over 2 meters. Upside, and then it will go down again 3 over 2, and then it will go up again 3 over 4 from 3 over 2, 3 over 4 times 3 over 2, how much? 9 over 8. So it will go up again 9 over 8, it will fall again 9 over 8, and so on until it stops. Okay, so we can write the series into 2 plus 3 over 2 for the distance, yeah. The distance of the ball is 2 plus 3 over 2 plus 3 over 2 plus 9 over 8 plus 9 over 8 plus something 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 until it infinite, until it stops. Okay, so I can say this is an infinite series from here. 3 over 2, 9 over 8, and so on, and so on, and so on. Let's prepare them. For A, I can say it's 3 over 2. Later, I will tell you why I do not use this A. Okay? Since 2 is the first, but I don't want to use the 2, I will tell you the reason later. Yeah? R equals to, from 3 over 2, it will become 9 over 8. So the ratio will be 9 over 8 over the before it, 3 over 2. 9 over 8 divided by 3 over 2, it will become 3 over 4, yeah. 3 over 4. So the ratio will be this one, 3 over 4 times. Okay. So I get the A and I have the ratio, and we know that the series is infinite series, we can find the distance of the ball by S infinite. S infinite is A over 1 minus R. The A is 3 over 2 over 1 minus R, 3 over 4. 3 over 2 over 1 over 4, it will become 6, ya. 4, 2, 6. Okay, good, 6. Be careful, we have we have twins, ya. We have two infinite series. The one is the red and the second one is the green. The numbers is exactly the same, but because the ball is bouncing back to the top and then falls again, so it will generate two geometric sequence or two infinite series, ya. So this 6, so the distance traveled by the ball is 6 times 2. Why times 2? Because we have two sequence exactly the same, ya. So 6 times 2, and then for these two we add the distance with 2. Why I do not use A equals to 2? Because these two is only one, ya, single, ya. There are no two here. So the sequence should be start from 3 over 2, ya. Do not start from 2, because since it's only the 2 is alone, ya. This 3 over 2, we have 2, both of them. And then 9 over 8, we have 2, and then this so on, we have 2, okay? But the 2 is alone, so we cannot use A equals to 2, we cannot use. And then the distance will be 12 plus 2, the result will be 14 meters. Okay guys, if you don't get it, you can ask me. As usual, I will tell you and I will explain it to you until you get it, okay? Thank you guys, bye-bye.